I'm here today thanks to Dork's Music, and today I'm going to be looking at a couple of different bass clarinet ligatures. The ligatures I've got with me today are the Ishimori WoodStone ligatures. I've got two different designs I'm going to be looking at. The first one is the original design. This one comes in lots of different finishes. You can get all sorts of different materials for slightly different sounds. I've got the original gold-plated one here. And then the other ligature I'm going to be looking at is the Kodama 2 ligature, which is a slightly different design. I've played these original design ligatures on my saxophones for years, and I've recently just tried all the different finishes on B-flat clarinet. There's another video of those you can check out, and I really love those. So I'm looking forward to trying this on the bass clarinet. But anyway, I'm going to just have a play through a few things on both of them, and then I'll tell you what I think. And now this is the Kodama 2 ligature. So there you've heard two Ishimori WoodStone ligatures. We had the original ligature in gold plate, followed by the Kodama 2 ligature. Now, first impressions are both of these are great ligatures. They're subtly different in terms of sound and actually in response as well. This is the first time I've tried one of these Kodama 2 ligatures. I'm much more used to the WoodStone original ones. I play those on all my saxes, and I've tried all of those on clarinet as well. But if we start off with the original ones, what I like about that is the immediacy of the response. It's got a really great response across the whole range, and it lets everything speak really easily, at the same time giving you a really kind of warm tone, really nice depth of tone. If you are interested in that ligature, I'd recommend trying out the different finishes they come in. You can get these all on 14-day approval from Dork, so you can try out as many as you want, really. But all the finishes are subtly different. The gold-plated one I was playing there, that's actually the one I use on my alto and baritone saxes, and I find that's kind of probably the most direct sounding one. I find it speaks really easily with a great sound. But if you want a little bit more projection, you can try the solid silver ones, and some of the kind of the brushed satin and the copper ones are possibly a little bit darker in terms of sound. So if I come on now to this Kodama 2 ligature, this one's slightly different beast, I would say. It's for me, it's a slightly softer sound. It's kind of this very smooth, very even across the range. Again, it's got that lovely, rich woodstone sound. I find the sound isn't quite as immediate on this one as on the original. And I think that's partly what gives it the softness, and it's kind of trading off the different elements you want in your playing. For me, if I were going to pick one, I'd probably go with the original because that just suits my style of playing. But it's well worth trying out both of them and see which you prefer, because for some people, this ligature might just be perfect. Perhaps if you've got a naturally bright tone and you want to kind of take a bit of edge off it, or if you're looking for some real kind of mellowness in your sound, then this is a really brilliant ligature to try. So what I recommend is trying them out for yourself, see what you like. I think, as I said earlier, you can get these on approval for Dorks, from Dorks, so you can try them in the comfort of your home.